We will continue the ecological grouping of plants, that is the xerophytes, as far as the anatomical adaptation is concerned. The anatomical adaptation, whatever they enter that transverse section of the particular type of the stem, root and the leaf, that can give the anatomical adaptations. And this anatomical adaptation regarding the stem that we are going to see, that is in the xerophyte. Now the stem is the, whenever the, if you have taken the transverse section of the Casuarina stem, Casuarina it is the xerophytic plant, and here the particular type of the young stem of the Casuarina, if you have taken the transverse section of the young stem of Casuarina, the cuticle is very thick. So whenever the such a type of the entire that structure of Casuarina stem concerned, here is very thick cuticle, the epidermis, which is covered by the thick cuticles. So here it is a cuticle which is present on the entire upper epidermis. Especially the epidermal region that is covered by the help of the thick cuticle, and below it there is the epidermis is there. And below the epidermis there is a thick wall, below the epidermis there is a thick wall, parenchymatous cell, that is the hypodermis, a thick wall hypodermis is there. Why thick wall hypodermis? The rate of translation that will be decreased. There is a thick wall hypodermis. And you may say the cortex, hypodermal cell that form the cortex. So this is the thick cuticle, and here it is the epidermis. In the ridges and the furrows of the stem of Casuarina, this show the root hairs. Sorry, hairs. Hair-like outgrowth that is present in the especially in between the ridges of the Casuarina stem. So whenever the transverse section of Casuarina, that shows the such type of the structure, and then the total the sometime it is a green in color, a young stem, sometime the pellucid tissue that is also present within them. So such type of the chlorophyllous tissue that is present within them, like this, here it is, like this, this pellucid tissue that has been directly present below the entire that epidermis, and that form the part of the entire that cortex itself. And then there is the endodermis. This endodermis is like this, and then pericycle like this, rectangles are the rounded cells are there. These are the pericycle, and in beneath the pericycle there is the entire that vascular bundle, that is the what we used to say the phloem. And in beneath the phloem there is a cambium, which is a meristematic tissue, and this cambium that is followed by the xylem as such. This cambium, it is followed by xylem. Such type of the structure that you may see in the internal transverse section of the Casuarina as far as the anatomical adaptation concerned. So the cuticle is very thick, epidermis is well developed and very thick wall. Well developed mechanical tissue, or mechanical tissue that has been well developed within them, because that plant that could be withstand against any type of the external barrier, maybe the high velocity of wind concerns. Then the photosynthetic stem that possesses the chlorophyllous tissue. This is the photosynthetic stem. If it is green in color, that is the pellucid tissue that we may say. Pellucid tissue, that is the photosynthetic. This is the entire that stem concern. But whenever the transverse section of the adaptation is the entire that leaf concern, the leaf, the most important thing is the adaptation, anatomical adaptation in the entire that leaf concern. At that time, you will have to take a transverse section of perium. So the transverse section of perium, which is this, like this, here it is the entire that upper end. This is the upper epidermis, here it is upper epidermis, which is the epidermal cell which are present beneath it, and this is the lower epidermal cells are there, lower epidermis that form the epidermal cell. When we take a transverse section of the leaf of the nerium as such concern, because nerium which is a xerophytic plant as such concern. So this upper epidermis as well as the lower epidermis, which is also covered by the help of the thick cuticle. So this is the cuticle. which is also covered by the help of the thick cuticle, like this. This is the cuticle. And this is as far as the normal lip concern, as far as the normal transverse section of the lip concern. If so, they enter the spongy tissue, then palisade tissue, like this. The this form the mesophyll tissue. Mesophyll tissue. This palisade tissue. And in the center of the medullary portion, in the center of the internal transverse section of the lip of Nerium concern, there is a portion in the center that forms the vascular bundle. This is the vascular bundle, and this vascular bundle may present, this is the protodilate, then this is the what we used to say, the metadilate like this, and then protodilate like this. This is the protodilate and this is the metadilate. But when you take a basic structure or a basic concept of the internal transverse section of the Nerium lip concern, it shows a sunken stomata here. The sunken stomata. Presence of sunken stomata, this is a peculiar characteristic of the internal Nerium lip, because the stomata are embedded within the palisade tissue. These are the palisade tissue. And these stomata are embedded in the internal palisade tissue, with the stomatal hairs are present in the transverse section of the Nerium lip. These are the stomatal hairs. And these stomata are present within the internal palisade tissue. It means that they are embedded in the palisade tissue. And that is why this is a peculiar characteristic, this is the important characteristic due to which the rate of transpiration that can be decreased by the help of this sunken stomata. When stomata are embedded in the palisade tissue, that is called as the sunken stomata. And this sunken stomata, it is the important feature of the xerobiotic plant as well as the lip concern. The lip possesses the epidermis with thick cuticle, sunken stomata are present on the lower side, mesophyll tissue is well differentiated into palisade and the spongy tissue, and the mechanical tissue is also well developed within the internal xerobiotic, especially the transfer section of lip, as well as the Nerium concern. Now the next group that we are going to see that is the halophytes, fourth group, halophyte. These are the group of the plants, and this plant that can show near to the internal seashore. Especially the saline water is there. The saline water that directly indicates there is a huge amount of the internal that MgSO4 or the NaCl, that is the saline, that is the salt. Salt is more, and due to adaptation or due to the adaptive power that has been acquired by the help of the effect of the plant, some adaptive power that can directly withstand against the such a type of the internal salt which are present in the soil. Because the soil contains more amount of salt, and the plant should have shown their existence within that plant, and that is why the particular type of the adaptive character that are present within this such type of the plant, that is called as the halophyte, especially they can show their existence near to the seashore, that is in the saline soil or the saline water also. Lot of times we used to go in the internal seashore at that time, the mangroves that we used to see. These are the mangroves, and these mangroves, for example, the Rhizosporum micornata, Avicinia, these are the particular type of the internal mangrove plants are there. They can show the morphological adaptation, that is in the form of the root also, that is in the form of the leaf, that is in the form of the stem also. So the such a type of the morphological adaptation that has been present within them. For example, the root concern, the root adaptation concern, the roots are present beneath the soil, but due to the depositions of the particular type of the salt which are present within that soil, and to overcome this problem, the plant wants to show the resistance. To overcome this such type of the problem, it is necessary to adapt itself with the environment in a such way that the breathing roots arise from the soil. And this breathing root arise from the soil in the
form of the large tentacle, large pointed outgrowth. And these pointed outgrowth that are in the form of a such type of structure, and this is called as the nematophore. These are called as the nematophore. And this nematophore possesses the such type of entire holes, or these holes, that is the pores. These pores are called as the lenticels. As far as the morphological adaptation, that is in the root and the stem concerned, this root, especially the root concerned, such a type of thing that pointed out to that have been arise from the soil. These are the breathing root, and this breathing root possesses the pores by which there is the gaseous exchange in between oxygen and CO2. That is take place in them by the help of this lenticel. Such a type of the adaptation which are present within them. The cork is interrupted by the help of the lenticel. The cork, that is especially the cork that formed by the help of the epidermis, when epidermis which will become mature, when epidermal cells that will become very thick, at that time the cork that has been formed, and this cork is interrupted by the help of the lenticel. Presence of the primary and the secondary cortex which are present in the cork, primary and secondary cortex. At the same time, multilayer sclerates are present in, especially within the interbed cork also. The stems with broad pith, that is also present within them. At the same time, the aerial root, that is the lacunate radial root or oil drop, which are also present within them. The stem modification concept, the stem is a cuticleized epidermal cell. The second, that is it may contain the large hypodermal cell, and within the stem there are the resins, there are the oil globules or oil glands are present within them. And these oil glands are resins which are present in the pit region, that is in the form of the tannin also, or that is in the form of the oil globules also, which possesses the X-shaped spicules which are present within them. As for leaf concern regarding the entire that rhizosporum acarinata, the leaf concern, it possesses the thick cuticle epidermis with the calcium oxalate crystal. Because the calcium oxalate crystal, that is crystal that has been formed due to accumulated quantity of the entered salt. These are the salt crystals, and these salt crystals which are present in the form of the entered oxalate, calcium oxalate in the leaf. At the same time, the presence of the sunken stomata with the thick cuticle-like stains, a thick cuticle-like leaf, that is also present within the subtype of the plant. Mesophyll tissue is differentiated into palisade and spongy tissue when we take a transverse section. So you may refer the book and you may sketch the diagram of the stairs of time of the rhizosporum acarinata, or what we used to say Avicinia also. Rhizosporum acarinata, stem of rhizosporum acarinata, at the same time tears of leaf of the rhizosporum acarinata. You can refer that figure which is given in the entire book. Okay, here ends the ecological groups of the entire ecological grouping of the plant.